Listening Library presents Not Really Buddies by Jan Carr. Read for you by Ramón de Ocampo. For Joanna Robledo, who set down roots and blazed brightly as a maple. And for Phoebe Lee Carr, happy sapling and my go-to kid consultant, JC. For the kids, George, Cammy, Peter, Camille, Dilly, Francie, Ori, and Lee, KM. 2108. Chapter 1. Surprise. The light turned green. Walk. Buddy started to step off the curb. Zoom! A car sped past. Whoops, Buddy had forgotten to look. There were lots of busy streets on the way to school, and a lot of zooming traffic. He jumped back. His cap fell off. Careful there, Buddy, said Poppy. Lots of parents called their sons Buddy. But Buddy's name really was Buddy. Dado picked up Buddy's cap and set it back on his head.
And hang on to that today, he said. Okay?
I'll try, said Buddy.
Buddy was good at losing things. That's because he was absent-minded. That's how his dads always explained it. They didn't mean Buddy was absent, just sometimes his mind was.
You're a dreamer, Poppy would say.
Our pokey little daydreamer,
Dado would chime in. And then both his dads would hug him.
Yeesh.
Buddy reached for Poppy's hand to cross the street.
What class am I in again?
He asked. On the first day of school, there was always a lot to remember.
2108, said Poppy. Right, said Buddy.
The two part meant second grade, and 108 was his room number. Poppy squeezed Buddy's hand.
I have a good feeling about this year, he said.
Me too, said Buddy. All my friends are in my class. Joey and Kaveh and Malik and Omar.
That had never happened before.
And me, said Amber.
Amber and her mom had slipped up behind them. They lived in Buddy's building.
Yeah, said Buddy. Plus, we have the best teacher in second grade, Jabari.
Jabari? Asked Dado. Is he your teacher this year?
He looked unsure. Buddy nodded.
Jabari's a bird watcher, he told Dado. He takes his class bird watching, and he lets us call him by his first name.
Amber scrunched her face. She turned to her mom.
Do we have Jabari? She asked.
I don't know, said her mom. They never tell us ahead of time.
It was true. The school never said which teachers would be in what room. Not before school started. They kept it a secret, like a surprise party. But Buddy was sure. It would be Jabari. By now, they were at the front gate. A crowd of kids was trying to cram through to the schoolyard. It was a jam-up, like when ketchup gets stuck in the neck of the bottle, and you have to give it a whack so it splatters out. Poppy straightened Buddy's cap.
Go get him, Buddy, he said.
You're going to rock second grade. Buddy took a big breath. The crowd looked, well, crowded.
Make way, he said.
Nobody budged.
Coming through!
Maybe he hadn't said it loud enough. He hesitated. Should he just push in? Amber elbowed past Buddy.
Incoming!
She yelled. Buddy squeezed in behind her, following in her wake. Splat! The two of them spilled out into the schoolyard. Amber spied the sign for their class across the yard.
There, she said. 2108.
Buddy pushed his glasses higher on his nose. A lot of his friends were already standing by the sign.
Joey, he called. Joey was with Kiko and Marisol, and Tamar and Priya. Everyone was gathered around Priya. Buddy and Amber joined them.
Guess who our teacher is?
Priya was saying. Her mom was class parent, so sometimes Priya knew things other kids didn't.
Jabari, said Buddy.
Nope, said Priya.
He is, said Buddy,
which means we'll go bird watching in the park with binoculars.
No, said Priya. I told you, not Jabari.
But he is, said Buddy. I know.
How?
Asked Amber.
Because, said Buddy, at the end of first grade, Jabari passed me in the hall on the very last day, and he winked at me.
So?
Said Priya.
It was a big wink, like he was telling me something, like he was saying, I'm going to be your teacher in the fall.
That didn't mean that, said Priya.
It did.
It didn't.
I could tell, said Buddy.
Joey pointed.
Jabari!
There he was, walking toward them. Jabari had a fresh-cut fade with an afro on top. He waved at them.
Ha!
Buddy grinned. But then, Jabari kept walking. He walked to a different sign. 2-1-10.
Wait.
Oh.
Buddy's face fell.
See?
Said Priya. Someone else was walking toward them. Another grown-up. She was wearing black leggings and a swingy skirt. Her hair was plaited in a thick braid slung over one shoulder. Buddy had never seen her before.
That's our teacher, whispered Priya. She's new.
The teacher smiled.
Hello, class 2108, she said.
Buddy made a face.
You're not Jabari, he said.
That didn't exactly come out right. It didn't sound friendly.
No, she said. I'm Ms. Maple.
Ms. Maple? What kind of name was that? A tree name? Buddy wondered if she'd take them to the park to see trees instead of birds. They probably wouldn't get to use binoculars. Buddy turned to look back at Jabari's class. Lucky class. Lucky kids. He fell in line with Joey. They all followed Ms. Maple into the school. Chapter 2. The Opposite of Pink. Inside the classroom, the kids all sat on the rug. It had squares with different colors. Buddy had raced for a purple one. Ms. Maple was already talking.
Oh, Buddy forgot he was supposed to be listening. He'd still been thinking about Jabari.
Ms. Maple seemed to be telling them about a first day project.
I want us all to get to know each other, she was saying. But first, we have to take care of some housekeeping.
Housekeeping? Like cleaning? Buddy raised his hand.
The tables are already clean, he said.
Ms. Maple blinked at him.
Tables?
She seemed confused.
Yeah, said Buddy. The whole classroom is clean. In this school, we wash everything at the end of the year, because we were the ones who made it dirty.
Oh, said Ms. Maple. Housekeeping. I can see why you thought I meant cleaning. I just meant chores. Our classroom chores. But it sounds like you're good citizens at this school.
Buddy nodded. He was definitely a good citizen.
Ms. Maple was new, and she didn't know anything about the school.
He was happy to help her, even if she wasn't a bird watcher. Ms. Maple took out her attendance list.
Housekeeping, she said, waving the list.
She smiled at Buddy.
The light kind.
Buddy had no idea what she meant by that. Was Ms. Maple going to be the kind of teacher who didn't always make sense? Some grown-ups were like that. You never knew what they were talking about. Ms. Maple started calling out names,
one by one.
Buddy Finley, she said.
Buddy raised his hand.
That's me.
But when Ms. Maple got to the next name, no one answered. It was B. Somebody. Buddy'd never heard of her.
Who?
Said Joey.
Does anyone know B? Asked Ms. Maple.
Nobody did.
She must be new then.
New and a no-show. Buddy grinned. There had been one of those last year. A new kid who never showed up. Joey had saved a seat for her at their table.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.